This data center is dedicated to one job and one job only: running AI models and generating intelligence. It's an AI factory.
Did you know that NVIDIA has an incredible $1 trillion market value? On May 30, 2023, it became a member of the $1 trillion club, joining elite companies such as Google's Alphabet, Apple, Microsoft, and Amazon. It's the first chip company to accomplish this milestone. While this success coming from Wall Street's growing fascination with AI, as more and more tech companies rush to integrate generative AI tools into our products. What does NVIDIA have to do with generative AI in the first place? Well, NVIDIA is a chip manufacturer and it supplies chips to major companies like Microsoft and Google. These chips assist in training large language models for generative AI, which power advanced chatbots like ChatGPT and Google Bard. So, how did NVIDIA become such a significant player in the tech space? How it became so successful? This is the story of how NVIDIA became a $1 trillion company. Let's go back to the start. A relaxed evening in April 1993, at the modest Dennis Roadside Dinner in East San Jose, three innovators set out on a journey that would transform computing history forever. Jensen Huang, an electrical engineer full of ideas, joined forces with Chris Malachowsky, who's passionate about tech from Sun Microsystems, and Curtis Priem, an experienced graphics chip designer, sitting over coffee and sharing their aspirations. They brought NVIDIA to life. Their mission: to lead the way in accelerated computing, a world where graphics-based processing could tackle challenges beyond the reach of traditional computing. Why? Because they saw opportunities where others saw limits. They realized that video games weren't just popular entertainment. They presented intricate challenges that could push computational boundaries in the future. The NVIDIA H100 Tensor Core GPU, if you think about it today, costs around $35,000. However, when NVIDIA started, they only had $40,000 in their pocket. What would you do with $40,000?
A luxury tour, a high-spec gaming PC, or a shady fixer-upper? Well, if you're determined to do something, nothing can stop you.
But they leverage this humble budget and, of course, with a strong belief in their vision, they laid a foundation for what NVIDIA would become in the future.
I don't know, $10 billion? The second one's five.
NVIDIA started in a tiny office in Sunnyvale, California. At first, they just used the letter N and letter V for their files, short for next version. But when they needed a real name, they found NVIDIA, which means NV in Latin, and it totally matched their ambition, hence the company name NVIDIA. NVIDIA's path to success was paved with strategic product launches and advancements in graphics technology. A key moment arrived in 1998 when they launched the Riva TNT, cementing their status as creators of top-notch graphics adapters. Yet, it was 1999 and truly changed the game. On January 22, they went public, marking a significant milestone. Shortly, they released the GeForce 215.6 NV10, a game-changing product that revolutionized consumer-level 3D hardware. This was the first to integrate onboard transformation and lighting, setting a new standard in the industry. Not long after, the company won a contract to develop graphics hardware for Microsoft Xbox game console, earning NVIDIA a substantial $200 million advance. Still, NVIDIA's engineers continue to deliver with products like GeForce 2, GTS in 2000 and the acquisition of 3DFX intellectual assets in 2002, further solidifying the company's market position. NVIDIA's success story didn't stop there. In 2004, they assisted Sony in designing the graphics processor for the PlayStation 3. The company also expanded its horizon by diversifying into gaming, automotive electronics, and even mobile devices. NVIDIA's commitment to innovation was evident with the launch of Tegra series Care for mobile devices in 2011, notably collaborations with major players like Toyota and Baidu, underscore their significant role in artificial intelligence and self-driving vehicles. In 2016, NVIDIA launched the GeForce 10 series featuring a Pascal microarchitecture and simultaneous multi-projection support, which enhanced multi-monitor and virtual reality rendering. NVIDIA jumped into AI by creating open-source ventilators during a global pandemic. This showed how much they care about tackling critical healthcare problems. NVIDIA made strategic moves like buying Mellanox Technologies in 2019 to grow in high-performance computing. A year later, they reviewed the Ampere microarchitecture and bought ARM from SoftBank for $40 billion, showing their drive to dominate the industry. Fast forward to 2023, they team up with Getty Images to roll out features leveraging Generative AI. Those features were powered by NVIDIA's state-of-the-art foundational model, 85. NVIDIA's financial journey ran parallel to its technological stride. In 2020, despite a 6.8% decline in annual revenue to $10.9 billion, NVIDIA still reported a profit of $2.8 billion. This step was offset by the surge in demand due to the pandemic, leading to Q2 2020 sales of $3.9 billion, a 15% rise from the previous year. The effects of the pandemic accelerated the adoption of NVIDIA technologies, especially laptops and virtual workstations, enabling remote work, crypto mining, and virtual collaboration. Throughout these shifts, NVIDIA showcased resilience and adaptability. But what's the secret behind their continued growth, and how they become dominant in the market? NVIDIA is making waves in the tech world by seamlessly integrating its GPU and DPU hardware accelerators with Kubernetes, one of the most popular cloud-native platforms for managing and automating containerized apps. The combination of Kubernetes and GPUs delivers unmatched scale for AI workloads. Kubernetes is designed to scale the infrastructure by pulling the compute resources from all over the nodes of the cluster. GPUs are used for massive parallelism required for training and inferencing of complex deep learning models. Currently, 48% of organizations use Kubernetes for AI and machine learning workloads, and the demand for such workloads also drives usage patterns on Kubernetes more and more significantly. You know, unlike CPUs that handle general computing tasks, GPUs specialize in graphics rendering and parallel processing, which is why they excel at tasks such as machine learning, deep learning, scientific simulations, as well as AI model training and inferencing, which is in high demand these days. By combining the scalability of Kubernetes with the parallel processing power of GPUs, NVIDIA has created an environment where AI workloads can thrive. Key platforms like NVIDIA, DGX, and EGX are already using Kubernetes at their orchestration layer, and NVIDIA is actively collaborating with platform vendors to smoothly integrate its cloud-native GPU infrastructure with Kubernetes. At the core of this transformation is the NVIDIA Container Toolkit, an extension to Docker Engine and Containerd. This toolkit simplifies the developer experience by exposing GPUs to containers, reducing the complexities associated with configuring the GPU software stack. Developers can pull a CUDA container image without the need to install the entire stack. By the way, CUDA is a parallel computing platform and programming model developed by NVIDIA for general computing on GPUs. It's highly portable and scalable across various environments, from high-end GPUs to edge devices like Jensen Nano. NVIDIA GPU Cloud serves as a central hub for cloud-native GPU-optimized AI resources. NGC also has its own container image registry called NVCR, which stands for NVIDIA Container Registry. Just like container registries at Docker Hub, it operates a marketplace for container images, including pre-trained models, Jupyter notebooks, popular helm charts such as GPU, Operator, and Jarvis, which is the NVIDIA platform for conversational AI. This helps streamline the workflow and makes it easier for developers to build AI applications. Kubernetes is great for optimizing resources and scanning worker nodes efficiently. However, it doesn't natively support scheduling and managing GPUs. To schedule GPUs in Kubernetes, we need something called a device plugin. NVIDIA, along with other providers like AMD and Intel, offers a device plugin for Kubernetes. This NVIDIA device plugin is part of the Kubernetes device plugin framework. It lets the Kubernetes agent know how many GPUs are available on each node of the cluster and monitors the health of those GPUs. NVIDIA even took a step further by building a GPU operator to simplify GPU management in Kubernetes. You see, to provision GPU worker nodes in a Kubernetes cluster, we always need some crucial components: the driver, container runtime, device plugin, and monitoring component. Using GPU operators, we can automate the management of our NVIDIA software components needed to provision GPUs. For instance, NVIDIA drivers, which are used to enable CUDA runtime. The Kubernetes device plugin exposes GPUs to Kubernetes worker nodes. The NVIDIA container runtime toolkit automates the node labeling and DCGM-based monitoring for managing and monitoring NVIDIA GPUs in large-scale Linux-based cluster environments. NVIDIA even committed further by building an entire stack of infrastructure automation tools called NVIDIA deepOps for Kubernetes and Swarm clusters with NVIDIA GPUs, which allows customers to get a fully configured cloud-native and GPU-optimized infrastructure in a matter of minutes. When it comes to training large language models, though, the truth is that machine learning jobs would need to span many Kubernetes nodes to take full advantage of GPU power. So, NVIDIA also developed GPU Direct for direct communication with a link or EV-Link for cross-communication with a GPU to maximize efficiency. They even developed what is called NVIDIA Network Operator to automate the deployment and configuration of the software required for accelerated networking. As a matter of fact, OpenAI is using these technologies to train large AI models, including GPT-4, DALL-E, and Sora. NVIDIA also developed a cloud-native stack to make the best use of computer resources. It's like a collection of software to run cloud-native workloads on NVIDIA GPUs. NVIDIA cloud-native stack is based on Ubuntu, Kubernetes, Helm, and the NVIDIA GPU and network operator. With a cloud-native stack, developers can create, test, and run containerized applications faster with GPUs. NVIDIA is making strategic moves to pave the way for future, where NVIDIA's integrated Kubernetes platform becomes the foundation for AI and high-performance computing infrastructure. With this forward-thinking approach, this is how NVIDIA transforms the landscape of modern AI development. By the way, we have made a playlist called Kubernetes in 30 Days about this fascinating technology. Check them out if you're interested. Do you think that NVIDIA's cloud-native strategy is driving their AI innovation? I want to know your thoughts in the comment section down below. If you're interested in receiving more content on a similar topic, you can subscribe to our newsletter. Links in the description. I will see you in the next one.